done. When it is truly time, if you have been chosen, it will do it by itself, and it will keep on doing it until you die, or it dies in you. There is no other way. And there never was. How to be a great writer.
You've got to a great many women, beautiful women, and write a few decent love poems. And don't worry about age and freshly arrived times. Just drink more beer, more and more beer. And attend the racetrack at least once a week. And win, if possible. Learning to win is hard, and a slob can be a good loser. And don't forget your bronze, and your bath, and your beer. Don't over-exercise. Sleep until noon. Avoid paying credit cards, or paying for anything on time. Remember that there isn't a price of ass in the world over 50 bucks. And if you have the ability to love, love yourself first. But always be aware of the possibility of total defeat. Whether the reason for that defeat seems right or wrong, an early taste of death is not necessarily a bad thing. Stay out of churches and bars and museums, and like the spider, be patient. Time is everybody's cross, plus exile, defeat, treachery, and all that drops. Stay with the beer. Beer is continuous love. A continuous lover. Get a larger typewriter. And as the footsteps go up and down outside your window, hit that thing. Hit it hard. Make it a heavyweight fight. Make it the bull when the first charge is in. And remember the old dogs who fought so well. Hemingway, Celine, Dostoevsky, Hamsun. If you think they didn't go crazy in tiny rooms, just like you're doing now, without women, without food, without hope, then you're not ready. Drink more beer. There's time. And if there's not, that's all right too.
So you want to be a writer? If it doesn't come bursting out of you in spite of everything, don't do it. Unless it comes unasked out of your heart or your mind and your mouth and your gut, don't do it. If you have to sit for hours staring at your computer screen or hunched back over your typewriter searching for words, don't do it. If you're doing it for money or fame, don't do it. If you're doing it because you want women in your bed, don't do it. if you have to sit there and rewrite it again and again, don't do it. If it's hard work just thinking about doing it, don't do it. If you're trying to write like somebody else, forget that. If you have to wait for it to roar out of you, then wait patiently. If it never does roar out of you, do something else. If you first have to read it to your wife or your girlfriend or your boyfriend or your parents or to anybody at all, you're not ready. Don't be like so many writers. Don't be like so many thousands of people who call themselves writers. Don't be dull and boring and pretentious. Don't be consumed with self-love. The libraries of the world have yawned themselves to sleep over your kind. Don't add to that. Don't do it. Unless it comes out of your soul like a rocket. Unless being still would drive you to madness or suicide or murder. Don't do it. Unless the sun inside you is burning your gut. Don't. When it is truly time, if you have been chosen, it will do it by itself. And it will keep on doing it until you die, or it dies in you. There is no other way. And there never was. How to be a great writer.
You've got to a great many women, beautiful women, and write a few decent love poems. And don't worry about age and freshly arrived times. Just drink more beer, more and more beer. And attend the racetrack. At least once a week. And win, if possible. Learning to win is hard, and a slob can be a good loser. And don't forget your bronze, and your bath, and your beer. Don't overexercise. Sleep until noon. Avoid paying credit cards or paying for anything on time. Remember that there isn't a price of ass in the world over 50 bucks. And if you have the ability to love, love yourself first. But always be aware of the possibility of total defeat. Whether the reason for that defeat seems right or wrong. An early taste of death is not necessarily a bad thing. Stay out of churches and bars and museums and like the spider, be patient. Time is everybody's cross. Plus exile, defeat, treachery, and all that drops. Stay with the beer. Beer is continuous blood, a continuous lover. Get a larger typewriter, and as the footsteps go up and down outside your window, hit that thing. Hit it hard. Make it a heavyweight fight. Make it debut when the first charge is in. And remember the old dogs who fought so well. Hemingway, Celine, Dostoevsky. become something. If you think they didn't go crazy in tiny rooms, just like you're doing now, without women, without food, without hope, then you're not ready. Drink more beer. There's time. And if there's not, that's alright too.
So you want to be a writer? It doesn't come bursting out of you in spite of everything, don't do it, unless it comes unasked out of your heart or your mind and your mouth and your gut. Don't do it. If you have to sit for hours staring at your computer screen or hunched back over your typewriter searching for words, don't do it. If you're doing it for money or fame, don't do it. If you're doing it because you want women in your bed, don't do it. If you have to sit there and rewrite it again and again, don't do it. If it's hard work just thinking about doing it, don't do it. If you're trying to write like somebody else, forget about it. If you have to wait for it to roar out of you, then wait patiently. If it never does roar out of you, do something else. If you first have to read it to your wife or your girlfriend or your boyfriend or your parents or to anybody at all, you're not ready. Don't be like so many writers. Don't be like so many thousands of people who call themselves writers. Don't be dull and boring and pretentious. Don't be consumed with self-love. The libraries of the world have yawned themselves to sleep over your kind. Don't add to that. Don't do it. Unless it comes out of your soul like a rocket. Unless being still would drive you to madness or suicide or murder. Don't do it. Unless the sun inside you is burning your gut. Don't do it. When it is truly time, if you have been chosen, it will do it by itself. And it will keep on doing it until you die, or it dies in you. There is no other way. And there never was.